No code app, more like no good app. I'm kidding. But for some founders, there may come a time when your software outgrows even the best no code app builders. And if I were you, I would want to get as much advance notice as possible. Here are three top signs it's time to transition an app or SaaS from no code to code. In this video, I'll be covering three signs your no-code app or SaaS will soon reach the limit of no-code app development and four things you can do from there. This video was inspired by a comment from a user called NoobieSnick. Specifically, the parts where he asked about me helping with transitioning from Bubble to custom app development. And I told him the same thing I've been telling all of you. Bubble locks in users, so transitioning from Bubble is building from scratch. By the way, sorry for assuming your gender, NoobieSnick. YouTube tells me my channel is an absolute sausage fest. Good thing I like sausage. My breakfast choices aside, NoobieSnick's experience isn't unique, as I will show in this video. Except for the simplest of app and SaaS use cases, a software product will eventually need at least some amount of custom development, not just custom coding, but just improving. Yes, even if you're using the almighty Bubble, the most powerful no-code app builder in the universe and God's gift to mankind, eventually you'll hit a limit. And here are the three signs that limit is approaching. First sign, you need lots of out-of-the-box features. Before I mumble on, let me show you a thread on the no-code subreddit from a non-tech founder. It's a long one as you can see, but I fully recommend checking it out. Link to it will be in the description, but here's the too long didn't read version. OP had minimal coding experience and used Bubble to connect to YouTube's API to track view count and revenue for a video he made. He struggled like mad to make it work with Bubble's pre-built solutions. Experience breakdown due to difficulties, but then he was inspired by the birth of his child to learn Python. Python was way easier and OAuth libraries simplified authentication. OP learned Python basics in a few days, wrote his own scripts for YouTube API, and realized coding is less mentally taxing than using no-code platforms for unique tasks. How many of us have the luxury of giving birth to a newborn baby to inspire us every time we face a problem? No-code solutions are meant to address common use cases. The more niche you need to go, the closer you are inching towards custom development. Because most of the time, no-code means working with a template. A no-code template is made up of code, someone else's code. When you try to do something not in that template, you're asking the code to do something it's not meant to do. And that can sometimes work. You could turn an 8 sideways and get an infinity sign. But you know what you get if you turn a 4 sideways? You get a sideways 4. Sometimes you outgrow templates. I should mention that certain no-code builders allow for some customization, but not to the degree of custom code. Second sign, your app's performance slows down because of high usage. Especially when your app deals with high data volume, high numbers of simultaneous users, highly complex processing, all of the above. Back to Reddit. This time, the CS Careers subreddit, where we have an entire thread of tech folks complaining that their management is trying to force no-code app development in the company. It's not possible to quantify exactly what too much volume or too complex is. It depends on your app. You can't just say more than 100 users or 500 rows of data is too much for no-code. A no-code app could handle 1,000 users and it could crumble under less than that. In the example I shared, their no-code app was already struggling to keep up with 15,000 records and they transitioned to custom code and burned $1.3 million along the way. But inevitably, you'll get comments like this. And they could be right, but they don't know your app enough to make blanket statements like this. Fact is, your app is being well received. You have traffic, you have usage. Do you really want to risk losing all that because of bad performance and stubbornly trying to optimize your workflow? Third sign, you see high potential for enterprise clients. Let's be honest, when you are starting out as a founder, the real target audience is literally anyone willing to pay. You don't care if you're selling to Elon Musk or Yilong Ma as long as they have
money, money.
But given the choice, some of you really want to serve enterprise clients because they are the ones who have a lot of
money, money.
But enterprise clients are particular. a nice way of saying fussy. They have compliance requirements, shareholders, corporate governance, and need to project a certain image. Security, integrity, quality. They pay well, but they expect their money's worth. And that can put you in a difficult position with no code because of its customization ceiling. Let me give you a situation. You're on a call with a representative from a big company. They say, we need a solution that does A, B, C, and D. Your no-code solution simply can't do D. So you go, A, B, C is fine, but can you live without D? They're gonna say, no, we want A, B, C, D. You go, all right, give me 2 months to rebuild my product with custom code. They're gonna go, how about we give you 2 seconds to get the f*** off this call? They're not gonna wait for you. They're gonna schedule a call with the next shortlisted solution. If you feel like your software has the potential to solve enterprise level problems and you're in a financially secure position, investing in custom development as soon as you can makes your product more viable for enterprise B2B market. Take a look at no-code app builders with big clients. Bubble, Flutterflow, Plasmic, WeWeb. Were they built with no code? I'm not saying custom code guarantees enterprise clients will fall into your lap. I wish that were true. I would love for Tesla to sit on my lap. Yo, Elon, I've got a spot warmed up for you right here. But no code solutions will always be limited customization wise compared to custom code as long as you've got a competent developer. Facts. So let's say you are experiencing some or all of the signs above, and especially if you are experiencing 2 of them or all 3. Sounds like you're near or at the end of your no-code journey, but it doesn't mean you need to run straight for a developer. The way I see it, you have 4 different directions you can hit in. Hey guys, if you found this video useful so far, give me a like and subscribe for more. If it's been awful, share it with your worst enemy and make them listen to me. I don't care. I just want to be famous. 4 options when a product reaches the ceiling of no code. First option, do nothing. This only works if there's no risk of losing users. Instead, the risk is just that your app just stays the way it is right now. You won't grow, but you won't shrink. It's homeostasis. Not everyone wants to build massive apps and chase millions of dollars in revenue. Some of us would be over the moon at $1,000 a month. Some would be happy with $500, which I think has been proven time and time again are perfectly reasonable expectations from a no-code product. If you build a no-code solution that can stay this way and you want to just stay small forever, I don't see anything wrong with it. You're dead to me. Second option, move to a more powerful no-code app builder. You might be at the limit of your no-code app builder, but not at the limit of no-code app development. These are the ones that sell themselves on user friendliness or ease of use rather than promising comprehensive and customizable components. I'm thinking platforms like GoodBubber, Glide, or Wheezed. They absolutely have their place. They got you this far, didn't they? But now you might need to pass the baton to the likes of Builder.io, Plasmic, Retool, or any of the no-code app builders that offer more customization. And while you're at it, beyond just what you can do with the pre-built components, go for a no-code app builder that allows you to import code. That means you can actually create custom components outside of the no-code platform and integrate them into your app. It's not as bespoke as writing everything from scratch, but you can actually customize your app or SaaS to be unlike anyone else. A lot of the more powerful app builders offer this to varying degrees, but so far, Plasmic has been the best for me, at least for web apps. Third option, hire a developer and go custom. This is my recommended course of action if you already have decent recurring revenue and you want to begin approaching enterprise clients. There are 2 decisions to make when it comes to engaging developers. Freelancers versus agency and local versus offshore. And in theory, these decisions exist on a continuum of cost savings versus risk. I mentioned recurring monthly revenue would be real nice because it doesn't really matter which of these choices you go with. It's going to be more expensive than a no-code solution. The way you hire an offshore developer is no different than how you hire a local developer. But the higher risk means you can't afford to compromise. If you're worried and you can afford it, hire locally. Then if they turn out to be sh**, at least you can drive to where they live and beat them up. I'm just joking, guys. Use a phone book. It won't leave any marks. What? 4th option, learn to code yourself. Well, it's an option. There's nothing new I can bring to the table here. Ever since the first caveman learned to walk upright, non-technical founders have been asking whether they should learn to code. And for thousands of years, the developer community has been consistently saying the same thing. No, unless you're building a really technical product with a technical target audience, you as a founder don't really need to know anything about coding. But sometimes you can't afford a developer and you can't find a technical co-founder. Case in point, Adam Wan, who learned to code and built his own SaaS. He was convinced his product was a winner. He was also the only one convinced his product was a winner. What else are you going to do? Outgrowing no code isn't a bad thing. I've always said the best use case for no code is fast and cost-effective MVPs. So ideas that make it to custom development stages are already proven. If you think it's time to go custom and you like my dimples, apply to work with us and link is in the description. But I think option two, a more powerful builder, is the best first choice for many. I mentioned Plasmic. I recently did a review of them. Love what they've built. It's no code, but when their team says you can customize it, they mean it. Check out my review. There's a promo code that gets you 2 months unlimited use for free. Please subscribe and leave a like. Thank you for watching.